did you ever get a chance to see Ed Metz on a tablet like this? He, yeah, he, remember he had those old cameras?
Oh, yeah, he had antique.
He had all these old antique cameras.
Bending over.
I'd rather sit here. I get a better view.
It's so much nicer up here.
Yeah.
I said,
I need to go on this.
The first year I came out, I got in trouble for being down there. So every year I just come up here. I take photos for the windows.
First time I do. We shoot photos and video for marketing.
Oh, okay.
Good evening. Tonight we gather in the beautiful Lois Perkins Chapel on the campus of Southwestern University for the 106th offering of the annual candlelight service. It is a tradition which began in 1915. Let me begin by first extending a warm greeting from two very special people. First, our Southwestern President, Dr. Laura Trombley, and second, Assistant Vice President Lisa De La Cruz, who actually had the task of organizing this service during COVID times. Last year, you recall, this service had no audience present due to a COVID spike. This year, it is very good to have people present, even though COVID protocol has required limited seating. Now, it is the prayer of all of us that by next year, we will be able to return to full capacity in a joyful celebration. My name is Chris Harrison, and it is my privilege to serve as the liturgist and to welcome each of you here this evening. I have to tell you that I first attended this candlelight service 52 years ago as a freshman at Southwestern University. And I recall sitting in the balcony at that time, praying fervently for God to get me through organic chemistry. It didn't work. I should have partied less, prayed less, and studied more. But some very kind Southwestern professors took me on to the University of Texas Law School, and 25 years as a state and federal prosecutor, upon retirement on to seminary, and now 20 years in active ministry. And I learned a lesson that I simply pass on to you. As you sit here in this beautiful chapel and you listen to the wonderful music this night, you may feel the urge to pray. But I simply warn you, be careful in what you pray for. The God who revealed himself in a manger still has a most wonderful sense of humor. And God still works in very mysterious ways. Now, the season of Advent is a time of anticipation as we prepare ourselves for the light of God entering the world. Tonight, we hold a traditional Advent service, a service that celebrates Emmanuel, God with us, in a combination of first, scripture reading, the lessons of Advent, second, the rich carols and music, the sounds of this season. And third, candlelight as a symbol of the light and love of God entering a dark world, and how the light of God's love spreads, as it always has, from one person to another. Now, I hope that you will remember tonight the mentors, the professors, the loved ones, all the people who have enlightened your life, and how you now share that light. In this service, the words from both scripture and music teach us the gospel message of God's grace and love. Therefore, there will be, thankfully, no sermon, and also no offering. Instead, this service is a gift from Southwestern University back to this community and the many saints who have supported it now for 181 years since 1840. Tonight we will have 7 readers, all with strong ties to this university. They are listed there in the bulletin. 6 are distinguished alumni, and the 7th is a former senior advisor to the university president. The wonderful students in the Southwestern University Chorale are conducted by Dr. Beth Everett, and the university organist is Dr. John Pollard. My only other advice to you, to young and old alike, is to remind you that tonight, as it has for 106 years, it's a celebration. Enjoy this moment of the season, of family and friends, of the people that you love close at hand. Sit back, breathe deep, sing freely, and let your spirit be joyful. And please just remain seated as the processional hymn is number 250, Once in Royal David City.
Thank you.
enter our lives this night. As angels and archangels once proclaimed, "Be not afraid," bringing tidings of great joy. Slow us in our busy lives. Set aside our fears and troubling thoughts, that we too may hear that ancient message and learn to appreciate the gifts of life and holiness in each moment and in all the people that surround us. Illumine our paths with your heavenly light, that we may clearly see the way before us, the truth we need to speak, the actions we must take. May we enter now into the mystery of creation, that weary hearts may grow strong with hope, and that all our moments may be filled with your grace. In this special season of Advent, may we, with those angelic hosts, proclaim, "Christ is born in Bethlehem. Glory to the newborn King." Amen. The hymn is number 196.
Upon them hath the light shined. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end, upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice, from henceforth even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Amen.
From the first chapter of the Gospel of Luke. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end."
The third lesson continues our reading from the Gospel of Luke, using the for Jesus. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was made first when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished, that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest and on earth, peace, goodwill toward all. And it came to pass as the angels were gone away, said to one another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord has made known unto us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger.
Child was. When When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. And going into the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. Then, opening their treasures, they offered him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh. And being warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed to their own country by another way.
The sixth lesson, the invitation to respond to the God of love from the first letter of John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is from God. Everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, for God is love. God's love was revealed among us in this way. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him. In this is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the atoning sacrifice for our sins. Beloved, since God loved us so much, we also ought to love one another. We love because he first loved us. Those who say, "I love God," and hate their brothers or sisters are liars. For those who do not love a brother or sister whom they have seen, cannot love God, whom they have not seen. The commandment we have from him is this: those who love God must love their brothers and sisters also.
In a few moments, we will hear the words from the first chapter of John, as the gospel writer tells of the light of God entering the world. After that, we will sing Joy to the World, and then the lights will go down, and as our readers come forward, we will begin sharing candlelight throughout the chapel. Now, let me just share with you a word of advice. When you have a lighted candle, keep it upright. Keep it straight up. As you pass the flame to the next person, let them tilt the unlighted candle to receive the flame so that no wax is spilled and no fires are started. In this way, there will be no bonfires, and we will still be able to enjoy this beautiful chapel next year. At the end of the service, we will follow the choir out of the chapel and there extinguish the candles, placing them in boxes just outside the chapel doors. And now, the seventh lesson from the Gospel of John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and Christ did not overcome it. From his fullness, we have all received grace upon grace. Please stand for the hymn, Joy to the World.
Thank you.
darkness did not overcome. Celebrate this season and let that light with your gifts, your words, your actions. And take up the challenge given to us to carry the light of God into that dark world. In a poem called The Work of Christmas, Howard Thurman, the former dean of the Boston University Chapel, summed up that challenge with these words. When the song of the angels is stilled, when the star in the sky is gone, when the kings and princes are home, when the shepherds are back with their flock, then the work of Christmas begins. To find the lost, to heal the broken, to feed the hungry, to release the prisoner, to rebuild the nations, to bring peace among all persons, to make music in the heart, giving glory to God. And may the blessing of that God, of love and peace for all, be ever with you. Amen. Ron, if you will lead us, not forget.
Lord, now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace, according to thy word. For my eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles, and to be the glory of thy people Israel.